Do you remember the boxes?
What boxes?
These boxes.
Huh.
You do remember them?
Oh yeah, yeah, I do remember them. They're variables where you can put the value inside.
Yeah, and you can combine multiple of these variables to create a larger Java object.
Oh, okay, so you can take two or more variables and make into something bigger.
Exactly.
Okay. Like a text view.
Yeah, so we can have an integer variable.
This is for the font size.
Exactly.
Okay.
And then you can also have a string variable.
And the string variable for the actual text itself.
Yeah. And those can go inside the text view as the state of the text view.
And then we can interact with those things using different methods that we're going to play with next.
Exactly.
Okay, let's do that.
As we mentioned earlier, showing a text view on the screen like this is actually controlled by a Java object within the app. This is an example of a TextView Java object. It's like a box, and inside of it, it holds state. The state is made up of a bunch of fields. A field is a variable, like in lesson 2 when we learned about global variables. We can have a text field to store the today string, which is going to be the text that's ultimately displayed on the screen. We can also have an integer field to store the font size of this text. There's also a bunch of other fields like text color, font family, that make up the state of the text view. I just didn't draw them in this picture. To interact with this Java object and change it while the app is running, we can call methods on the text view. We learned about methods earlier in lesson 3. Some example methods on a text view are setText and getText. You can also have methods like setTextSize or getTextSize and so on. Each of these methods just executes a list of instructions. You can have more complex methods like onDraw, which handles drawing the text view onto the screen. So overall, this text view object holds state information on what this text view contains, and you can call methods to interact with this text view, such as to modify the state or to do more complex actions. To show an image view on the screen, we actually have a Java object for image view inside of the app. This particular image view contains state information, like which image should be shown, as well as the scale type, like center crop. Again, there's a bunch of other fields that make up the state of an image view. I just didn't draw them here. There's methods like setImage, setScaleType, and even more complex methods like onDraw to handle drawing this image view onto the screen. Note that as developers, we don't explicitly have to call onDraw to tell it to draw onto the screen. Android handles calling this automatically for us. But it is useful to be able to call these methods to change the image view, for example. So how do we know what all the fields are inside the state of an image view and what all the methods are of this image view? To answer that question, we have to look at the class definition for that object. It's a file called textview.java, similar to how we defined mainActivity.java. Inside this class textview file, we have a bunch of code that talks about the state of the textview as well as the methods. Now, it doesn't say state and methods exactly, but it just contains information on the state and contains information on the methods. You can think of this as defining the rules of how a text view behaves. This object instance can hold specific information like the text string today or the text size 18. You can also use this class to create even more text view object instances. And these could have a different text string value, like this one could hold text that says hello, and this one could hold text that says goodbye. They could have different font sizes, different text colors, and etc. However, they're all based off of the class template. You may find it hard to distinguish between a class and an object instance, but that's okay. It takes some time to get used to. Here's an analogy to help you. You can think of it as creating a floor plan for our house. You can use this floor plan to create the actual homes. Each of these homes can be slightly different, but they're all based off of this base floor plan. It's important to note that the floor plan is not a house itself, it's just a plan. Similarly, the TextView class is used to create these object instances. So these instances are the ones with the actual text values, text color values, and text sizes. So what does one of these classes look like?